Hello everybody, and welcome once again to Let's Play Skyrim. Last time we, for the most part, re-cleared the Valfheim Towers. There are a couple of Silverhand left inside. We are here to steal plans. And because I'm trying to keep honest track of kills for my werewolf perks, I note that I have 5 more silver hand to eliminate, or, well, not necessarily silver hand, 5 more human corpses to devour before I should be able to at least theoretically unlock the 4th werewolf perk, which is a very important one. Savage feeding that allows us to feed on creatures as well as humans. I only came over here because I was certain there was upland somewhere. There it is. Thunder God. Like I was worried about when I was watching earlier, another one has fallen and died. That's actually fine. Let's just make sure we get this corpse devoured. Four more till we should have the next perk. So I guess that means the only thing left is that one archer that I can see at the top of the first tower. Then it's just a matter of clearing out the spot. Pretty close to needing an offload. But not... Well, I still have 60 pounds of carry weight. That's not awful. I am actually going to, since I keep having to re-equip it, I'm going to favorite all the gear that I currently like to wear. Just so I stop losing track of it. Alright, now we're up here. Head to the top of this tower first. Sure enough, some stuff has respawned, some hasn't. That's exactly what I expect for repeat locations. Get all of her stuff.
Now you're mine.
Yeah.
dang.
Boost!
Oh. Didn't quite shout in time. Ridiculous. Come on now. Come on, Meow. There we go.
You won't get the best of me.
Boost!
Thing I'm not in the air, isn't it? I do find it a bit odd that telling me I'm too close to her to wait, but what I should do is just hit her. Then flame on again. Because magicka refills so much faster than health.
Ha! Found it! Ah! Yeah.
Now, if you ask me, that was actually awesome. I just wish, you know, destruction had gone up. That's all. First things first, let's heal up. Trying, sweetness.
Oh well. Must have run off.
Well, that was a mistake, but all it'll cost me is a few seconds of time.
What was that?
Seriously? awesome. Good night. £15 left. Probably not enough for everything I'd like. But let's make it a little easier. By running out and then coming back in. If that makes sense. For everything I... Well, eh. Do it in order. I think I TCL'd this last time and I didn't need to, obviously. We do have perfectly usable iron ore vein and two corundum/corundum ore veins that have respawned that I feel like I probably need to come back for. Place is already clear. Just a matter of looting it out and then seeing what the next Radiant Companion quest is going to be.
Ugh. Been tending to your hounds?
Oh, come on.
Smell like a wet dog.
Not this crap. There we go. Head inside our house.
Get a few gold to spend?
Sure.
Thanks, Pa.
There's another silver ore. The only thing she's got in there that still matters is the Sabre Cat tooth. I need 7 more of those. I'm actually, I think, about to get another gold ingot. Because I have 2 in there, so that'll drop me to 1. Or, I mean, I've got a gold ore in there. I just picked up another, which I can transmute to silver. Excuse me. Let's try again. Number 1. I need 2 more gold ingots. Number 2. I already have 1 gold ore sitting in there.
Three,
Lucia just gave me another silver ore.
Play with her anymore.
Number 4, I can transmute that to a gold ore, like I just did. And finally, I'll be able to turn those gold ingot I need.
Papa!
In just a moment. 2 corundum veins. I can just leave
that
one in there.
Do you need something, Papa?
It'll be 3 ingots. Up here. Illusion 73. I love that. I have no stolen stuff. I have no unique stuff. I do have... Sabre Cat tooth Lucia just gave me. I think that's it in terms of stuff that actually needs to go be stashed up here. things for now. Something?
What do you need, my friend?
Go cast your fancy magic someplace.
Yes. 7 more saber cat teeth and 1 more gold ingot.
List. Someone took
some goody.
Got some good pieces. Blades, helmets, pretty much anything to suit your needs. Don't forget to check inside the shop if you need anything.
There's that gold ingot.
I don't claim to be the best blacksmith in Gotham. Yorland Greymane's got that on.
Well, let's roll back in here. Drop our gold ingot upstairs. Bellathor to get rid of junk. Bellathor may not be open.
Whoa.
I think he opens at 9, so we'll give it 2 hours.
It's the magic!
Got something for just about everybody. Trinkets, odds and ends, that sort of thing.
Very good.
Do come back.
Now we'll head back to Valheim Towers.
Go cast your fancy magic some... Sir.
It should be a fairly easy batter to finish things off. One thing does occur to me. I never did, that final arch works. Probably get beast form ready and do that before it disappears. And by my calculations, that leaves me needing 3 more before I can legitimately take the next one. Gives it to me earlier than that. Alright, 3 more. Just for my own, perhaps sadistic masochistic edification, I'm gonna check and see how destruction's doing. I put forth the effort to use it to kill these guys. It's quite a frustrating effort, I might add. I really have to be able to isolate individual melee fighters for it to have any chance at all. So what's it doing? I remember where it was. Oh! Okay, that's actually not nearly as terrible as I would have guessed. It's trucking. It's just going to be a long 61 ranks. Unless we find a better spell or I max out my crafting skills. And get free casting. Even if I do that, it'll still be a long haul if I have to do it with flames. These are the rules of the Ironborn. Let's mine these ore veins since they've respawned. I won't actually take them off the list till I smelt them, but this will be 3 Corundum ingots. That'll drop that total to 68. 3 more iron ingots will drop that total to 554. Where was the first one? There it is. An emerald! Hooray! Very good. Let's head upstairs now. A few things did respawn. Most did not. These are all set books, and I've already read to them all. First time I came here. You have to pick the novice lock again, even though we won't get experience the second time around. Shucks darn. Ebony arrows. Be kind to need if there were more of them. Save the boss chest for last. As always, it's the exciting thing. Now notice, I think I mentioned this way back in Anise's cabin. End tables, wardrobes, dressers, all safe storage. You might be noticing already, they never respawn. There's one other weapon under that bed. Let's go up here. Enchanted bow. Ah, it's just turn undead. Thought it was going to be banish. Already have turned undead. Whoopty freaking do. Alright, search the boss chest. Come on, good stuff! There's fortify destruction. Fortify con... Well, holy shit. The Dragonscale Shield. Now, the important thing to understand here is that I no longer need to make my own Dragonscale Shield. I do still need to improve it, but let me see. Everything else is pretty straightforward. Let me just see what that saves me. I can move. I can take 4 dragon scales off the list. And of the stuff that's already sitting in reserve, I've saved myself 2 iron ingots and 2 leather strips. Now that is cool. Is the Silverhand Stratagem actually a readable book? I can't tell. I don't think it is. completed. Steal the plans from Valheim Towers, return to Vaella. No, it's not. It's a junk item. Alright, let's head back to Whiterun. That's exciting. I'm gonna behave as though I found the four dragon scales, because that's essentially how it works. Well, no it isn't. Well, yes it is. I've saved myself those four dragon scales along with two iron ingots, and I can remove Dragonscale Shield from the list of things I need to create. That's all really cool. Let's switch back to courage. I bet you can do it. Before I forget those totals, I need to go fish the stuff out of the crafting box. Right here. Out come two leather strips and two iron ingots. Two iron ingots can jump right into here almost immediately.
Papa! Did you bring me anything?
Not this time.
Aww. Brief is a big and mean.
Two leather strips, meantime, go into smithing supplies. Dragonscale Shield, of course, goes in here. Stolen Elven Shield comes out. Stolen Elven Shield needs to go up here in stolen stuff. Yes, yes.
Papa!
Now I need to run out and smelt. That was an exciting find. Three Corundum ingots and three iron ingots. I think I already mentioned this, but oh well, the iron total changed because I was able to raid those two. I need 552 more iron ingots and 68 more Corundum ingots. And three additional iron and three Corundum ingots. Now it's time to offload. More fully, anyway. No enchantables. There were just a few ingredients. Everything I just smelted has to go upstairs, so there are no new smithing supplies. Nothing new for the crafting loop, either. Oh wait, I forgot about my gems. I do have a few smithing supplies. Figure. Alright, next, let me check my time. Both in and out of game. In game, I still have time to offload.
Take a good look around. I'm sure you'll find
my other stuff, which is
take a look.
Let me know. I might have it stored away.
Not interested in the blessed hunting bow or the orcish sword.
Good doing business with you.
To find Bellathor. Then we'll head to Yorvaskar and see what our second Radiant quest
maybe
will
some
be.
Other time.
There's 74 illusion. Shit just keeps going up.
Let me know if you see anything you like.
Don't mean to be rude, but I'm too busy to talk right now.
Some may call this junk. Me, I call them treasures.
Oh, yes. I forgot to look, but I believe I already have destruction and conjuration. And I'm never going to wear a circlet instead of a helmet, so let's just sell those. Potions, scroll, useless books, and wine.
Do come back.
Alright, now let's head to Yorvasker. Going to complete the quest Stealing Plans, and we'll find out if we get to do another one of the Silver Hand quests or not. Because, like I mentioned, we have to do two Radiant quests before we go back to the storyline. Aella offers us Silver Hand quests at this point only. When we complete the next story quest, we're locked out of those. I'm only going to do a second one. If she happens to give it in a location I'm happy with.
Go cast your fancy magic.
If she doesn't, I'll do a Radiant quest from somebody else. And we won't be doing either of the other two. Anyway, let's just see what happens. Got about half an hour to go. Feeling good.
I've been running interference around here. I don't think anyone... Have you been bringing the battle to the Silver Hand, friend? I wish I could be there with you. Soon enough.
I've got the plans.
Perfect. Hopefully this will let us know more about their movement. I think we've got them on the run.
Silverhand's stratagem removed. 300 gold added. Completed. Return to Aella. Completed. Stealing plans. Talk to the companion's leaders for work.
Until next time. I hope the hunting goes well, Heather. We've got the cowards on their heels.
So, we can talk to her or at somebody else. First, let's see where she wants to send me.
I've heard you may actually be stronger than you look. Perhaps we can hunt together someday.
What's the next target?
I've been hearing rumors of Silver Hand activity. A group of them is holed up in the rift. Run fast, my friend.
Should I be holding the blade further away than I
started? Striking the heart.
If you keep it in
assassinate
close.
The Silver Hand leader at Treva's watch. I actually think that's going to be acceptable to me. Oh yes. Okay, good. Well, in that case, we will just take that one. We've heard rumors of a Silverhand lieutenant camped at Treva's watch. With him dead, their forces should weaken. That does mean I get to do 2 out of 3, which is the most you'll ever be able to do. I will not be able to do retrieval, so I'm taking it off the list.
I have more control.
Because you will only ever get to do two Radiant Silverhand quests.
I like.
Exactly.
So, we are going to leave the companions for a while now. Let's return to Gallows Rock, briefly. Because we're going to do a little exploring. To do is pop in sneak mode, head southwest from here toward that giant camp. Gallows Rock shouldn't have respawned yet. It's clearable and it has not been 30 days. because it's a giant camp, I don't need to sneak, so... let's just go ahead and spam Mage Light on our way in. Shouldn't hurt anything. Just be mindful of our surroundings. These snow berries will definitely help me actually empower myself the next time I do an enchanting session. Human corpses. Giants can't feed on without the perk, so don't need to worry about werewolf stuff for a little while. Alright, we're almost here, so let me switch back to actual flames, and there is Cradlecrush Rock. Let me take it off my location list right quick. Got about 20 minutes left, doing well. Place is typically inhabited by a single giant. No mammoths, nothing else. Oh, there's a dragon about. That's a good thing, actually. I haven't fought a dragon in a while. What's it doing? Does it want to fight the giant? That'd be kind of fun. I know I want to kill that fox before it's able to go anywhere. That was awesome. Well, if the dragon were here to attack me, then he'd circle in on me. But he is hostile, so... it's not just a flyby, either. Oh well. This is Cradlecrush Rock itself. As you look around the rock, you can find three things, all part of some people that presumably the giant crushed with the rock. Over here by the skeletal legs, there's a knapsack. Let's just jump in there and grab another new book, Azir Trajijazeri. No idea if that pronunciation is correct or not. It's an interesting enough book. It's, I know it's Khajiit in origin. I think it might be, like, their code? The rules they live by? I'll just look at it right quick. Yes, yes, yes. It is good to be brave. It is necessary to run away. Yes, the rules to live by. Oh, I'm not sure what he's doing. Here's number two. You can take the skull. There's also a helmet of destruction. Ah. Yes, there it is. I don't think he was after me. This is another random encounter that's configured to happen, called Dragon versus Giant. Now, depending what kind of giant you can, what kind of dragon you're dealing with, giants are all the same. Frequently, the giant will win, at least at lower levels. However, it appears to me that what we've got here is, looks like an elder dragon, not dragon is going to win this fight. Anyway, also here, don't miss the ring right there on the hand. That might actually be everything. Yeah, the knapsack, the helmet, and the ring. Three items is the idea. Then over here, potatoes, cheese, leeks. Just gonna try and stay sneaky for the moment and get all this food. Because the dragon and the giant are occupied with the other. And the giant isn't hostile to me yet. Nothing important, but a few things to grab. And of course, the chest is always important, even when, as is the case this time, nothing good inside. There's another dead fox, no telling who killed it. I'll be disappointed if that dragon gets away entirely. I haven't fought a dragon in a while, and I still need 16 scales for the crafting loop. He's occupied with the giant, which is fine. I'd actually like to find this ore vein if I can, while I'm still hidden from everyone. Oh good, got it. Well, there's the giant. Like the dragon killed himself a bear. Note that it's an ordinary bear with the kind of pelt I still need. That's great. With that one in hand, I need 3 more. It's turned into a surprisingly productive little video. So, bear pelt in hand. Good, good, good. Oh, yes, get after the giant. You two, do it. Probably get my sword, get my bow out, get my nice set of 6 ebony arrows. So that I can help out the giant. Because he will lose. It's just the 2 of them. Especially now that he's fallen in there and become trapped. Hitting safeties into the league. Here. Just for giggles. don't have any empty greater soul gem, so I don't need to worry about trapping him. He does have a Sabercat snow pelt for me. That's good news because it leaves me only needing one more. My empty soul gems are either common or grand. Or lesser or any. Really anything but greater. Okay, well, his loot changed, so now I need two Sabercat snow pelts again, but he gave me a full Grand Soul Gem instead. Yes, I will make that trade in a heartbeat. Very good. Got about 5 minutes left now, probably not enough time to deal with the dragon, but you never know. Let's see. Suggest to myself, if nobody else, that I would save the giant down this time. Maybe see what we can do about getting up out of here. The giant couldn't. I think I'm at the abandoned. Will note that with that giant dead, Cradlecrush Rock is cleared. It's cool in its own right, so let me take it off the list. There it is. Cradlecrush Rock cleared. Outstanding. Now, what can we do about this dragon? Where the hell is it? That's question one. Way the hell over there. Way past my current range. But still very much aware of me, it would seem. I can just stay on his radar. He comes back over here. Re-engages me. That'll work very well for me. I missed me two good arrows, which I don't mind. I did hit him with one. And it looks like he's back on me, which is what I wanted. Yeah, buddy. Get in. Yeah, you and me, let's party. Still have a few minutes.
Papa!
Then suddenly you realize the very dramatic downside of the fact that you're captured by Dragon's Den. Hang there. It'd be great. He won't stay there though. They always take off after enough time on the ground. So it is here. Uh-oh. Spotted something else. Especially as long as he's in hot shot range, which he is for the moment. He's got a decent complement of dwarven arrows, that's good. Fight the mayor. For some reason the bear is hostile to me as well. Oh, come on! I didn't let go of there. When I'm sitting there, still holding the mouse button, and the arrow does that little half-ass firing anyway. Yeah, yeah. That turns me grumpy. One thing if I fuck up and let go of the button, but that didn't happen. Snowberry. Quite a while longer. Haven't had a chance to fight. We haven't had a dragon fight in a whole shit. All time. Well. Bit of damage. I was hoping to at least save the full health. In a reasonably safe spot, but dragon. Attention attack. I can reach that point again. That's where we'll save it. Let's get the bow back out. Alright, good. This is a great stopping point. This has been Let's Play Skyrim. We completed stealing plans. We found a boatload of actually useful stuff, and now we're fighting a dragon. Next time, we'll finish this dragon battle and then move on with our exploration. Until then, thank you very much for watching, and have a great day. Bye-bye.